Hi, this slide kicks off one of a subset of slides about one of my favorite, most powerful, underappreciated ideas in transforming a mediocre service environment to a high-performance one, and that is on Hexagon Boundary 2. A key input I'd like to measure is how many small win news items can we report on a weekly basis. And let me just jump into some of the sort of background assumptions. First of all, when we go and we talk to individual employees and say, hey, you know, do you see the vision? Here's what we're going to do, da, 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 and here's what's in it for you. There's a concept called the futility of individual action. In other words, you know, I'm one of 15 people at this branch. I'm one of 200, 300, 500, 8,000 at this chain. And now we have some corporate deal. And, you know, if the company does whatever, then in theory, I'm going to get a nickel at the end of the year or something. I mean, what can I in my little cubicle do to really matter? It's a little bit like, you know, who should I vote for president? Does it really matter? Because whoever even gets elected president, you've got basically a Congress that's owned by special interest groups and can't do anything. A super committee, you know, trying to resolve the debt ceiling crisis would be a good example of Congress not being able to do anything. So why bother? Why vote? Why put my oar in the water and pull when most of the other people are not doing it or not doing it as hard as I would be doing and so forth? So how do we overcome that? Secondly, when we say to everybody, oh, do you see the vision? Do you believe? And they all go, oh, yeah, boss, I do. But they don't all see it and believe it on a 10. Some people really are a zero and don't even know what you're talking about, but they're just telling you what you want to hear. So when it comes to the degree of buy-in and the persistence of that buy-in, that's a real continuum of things. So how do we constantly give everybody, whether they need it or not, more encouragement? A third problem is that whenever we do something new, there are going to be some people who, frankly, are going to have a kind of an active negative reaction to it. Like, well, I don't like this because it's really asking me to change what I'm doing, and I don't want to change. And you know what? I'm going to be persnickety about it, as opposed to being a passive resistor. I'm actually going to try to find other allies and, you know, be a little bit of a rebel and shout this down and say it won't stand, type of thing, as opposed to the passive resistors to say, you know what, I'm just going to say yeah, and forget about it. And in 3 weeks, this will pass because the inertia of the organization always crushes these new ideas. And then there are people who really don't care. They're just doing what they're doing. And coasters, free rent riders, these are people that frankly are getting overpaid for what they're not doing anymore. They had a great reputation. They've been living off it for too long as they started to retire and forgot to tell the company about it. That would be an example. Sometimes they are the biggest active negatives, but they certainly have no incentive at all of changing because they already got a good deal. And everybody else is sort of one more, but they really know that they're doing, you know, better than they should. So there are these kinds of different personalities that they're on a payroll, and we have to address them all. You know, how do we do this? And the solution down here is a constant stream of small win news. So what we're going to do is teach everyone what a praising statement is, how to design one, how to give one, and get it into the editor. You know, we have to somebody that gathers all these things and turns around and publishes them, perhaps electronically in today's world. And for the top 20% of the organization, as far as the payroll or whatever, they even have quotas on catching people doing things incrementally right and working at praising statements to get into the weekly publication. Now, there should be an opportunity to at least print it, perhaps, because sometimes these things actually literally go home and get put in the refrigerator because the Hoover got ink wants to circle their name, run home, show mom, put it in the refrigerator. That's just what people do. So this is something we want to do. Now, this raises questions about, well, what is a praising statement? What's the format? And how do you give them? And when do you give them? And all that sort of stuff. So we're going to look at those additional elements in the following few slides. Thank you.